5-minute bios, short on time, long on info, with George Fritchie. Today, Thomas Mann. Thomas Mann, one of the greatest German writers of the 20th century, was born on June 6, 1875 in Lübeck, Germany, and died on August 12, 1955 in Zurich, Switzerland. Mann received the Nobel Prize in Literature in 1929 and is best known for his masterful novels and stories, often dealing with the German bourgeoisie and its cultural traditions. Thomas Mann was born into a wealthy family. His father, Thomas Johann Heinrich Mann, was a successful merchant and senator of the city of Lübeck, Germany, while his mother, Julia Mann, came from a German-Portuguese family of artists. Thomas was the second of five children and the older brother of Heinrich Mann, who also became an important writer. After the death of his father in 1891, the family moved to Munich, where Thomas Mann finished his schooling. He first began to study natural sciences at the Technical University of Munich, but soon dropped out to devote himself entirely to writing. Thomas Mann's literary career began in 1898 with the publication of his first novel, Little Herr Friedemann. In the following years, he published further short stories and novellas, including The Buddenbrooks in 1901, his first major novel, which describes the fate of a Lübeck merchant family over several generations. The novel was a great success and established Thomas Mann's reputation as one of the most important German writers of his time. In 1912, Mann's famous novella Death in Venice, about a writer's obsessive love for a beautiful boy, was published, and later adapted into film by Luchino Visconti. During the First World War, Thomas Mann initially supported German war policy, but changed his attitude over time and increasingly advocated democratic and republican values in the 1920s. This political development is reflected in his novel The Magic Mountain of 1924, which depicts life and political debates in a Swiss sanatorium before the First World War, and which is considered one of his major works. When the National Socialists came to power in 1933, Thomas Mann's life changed dramatically. Because he publicly spoke out against the Nazi regime, his German citizenship was revoked and his books were burned in Germany. Mann emigrated first to Switzerland and later to the United States, where he lived in California from 1942 to 1952. During his time in exile, Thomas Mann wrote some of his most important works, including the novel Joseph and His Brothers from 1933 to 1943, a monumental tetralogy that reinterprets the life of the biblical Joseph in a historical and cultural context. Mann's political commitment also found expression in exile. He gave radio speeches for the Voice of America station and campaigned for the fight against National Socialism and the defense of democracy. One of his famous quotes, "Tolerance becomes a crime when applied to evil." One of the best-known works from Mann's exile is the novel Dr. Faustus, 1947, which depicts the life of the fictional German composer Adrian Leverkühn as an allegory for the rise and fall of German nationalism and fascism. After the end of the Second World War, Thomas Mann did not return to Germany, but moved to Switzerland with his family in 1952. There he continued his literary work and continued to be politically involved especially for reconciliation between Germany and its neighbors. Thomas Mann died on August 12, 1955, in Zurich, at the age of 80. His grave is in the Kilchberg Cemetery near Zurich. Thomas Mann is considered one of the outstanding writers of the 20th century and an important chronicler of German culture and history. His novels and short stories are characterized by a deep understanding of the human psyche, a critical examination of social and political issues, and a masterful style that combines both classic and modern elements. Mann openly shared his views regarding the difficulties of his craft and said, "A writer is someone for whom writing is more difficult than it is for other people." Well, so much for Thomas Mann. And until the next episode of 5 Minutes.